Thank you for joining us. The countdown is on at the state capitol with a lot left to do. In the last hour, Senate Republicans met behind closed doors with House Democrats offering up what they said was one final offer on police accountability changes. And some form of arbitration is included. Danny Spiewak live at the capitol with an update for us. Hi, Danny.
Well, Chris, this final offer from Senate Republicans basically proposed changing the arbitration process to allow for an administrative law judge to oversee some cases of officer discipline. It was somewhat of a compromise with the DFL, which had pushed for arbitration changes, but it was a much different proposal. And Senate Majority Leader Paul Gazelka admitted that he wasn't familiar with the House proposal on arbitration and that it wasn't a consideration when they made their offer. So it doesn't appear we're going to have a deal, because the DFL slammed the Republicans, saying that their new plan that they offered to the House Democrats was entirely inadequate. So it appears we're going to be leaving the Capitol tonight with no deal on police accountability. And I just want to show you some of the issues that are the sticking points here and the disagreements, just what some of the issues are on each side where they're not finding compromise, just to explain that a little bit for you. On the DFL side, some of their big key elements of their proposals have been, one, shifting the prosecution of police killings to the Attorney General away from local district attorneys. Number two is arbitration, but Representative Herr had offered a proposal that basically created a new panel appointed by the governor, was much different than what the Republicans came with today. And third, the DFL wanted new laws that would ban chokeholds specifically, as well as banning that warrior-style training that's been pretty controversial the last couple of years. And on the GOP side, some of the big parts of their proposals here this week have been funding for police training and crisis intervention, also changes to state standards, not necessarily state law, on chokeholds and use of force, as well as better data collection on police shootings. But I want to give you a little bit of an insight into what was just said to us in the last 30 minutes from both the Republicans and the DFL, as it appears they are not on the same page.
You can't say it's not a good faith effort. I think they had 22 provisions. This is a compromise at 11. And so I hope they take it.
You can see once again, there was no change in attitude, no change in behavior, and minor little tweaks. No major concessions in terms of what we wanted to do, just minor little tweaks.
So now the question is, what's next? Well, Senator Gazelka said that they still plan to adjourn tonight. It appears that police accountability might not get done. However, they are very close, both sides and leaders from both parties, on a COVID-19 funding bill. So it does appear that that may happen in the next couple of hours. Chris.
Danny, quick question. Does it appear that the leaders on both sides are at a complete impasse here, or is it something that they just don't want rushed?
I would describe it as a complete impasse. I don't think that the leaders from the Senate Republicans or the DFL, either in the Senate or the House, have really come to a consensus on enough issues. I think there are some issues where they seem to have some agreement, but not nearly enough. And it doesn't seem that either side is really willing to budge here.
All right, Danny Spiewak, live at the Capitol for us. Thanks, Danny.